Today's enlightening entertainment will be presented in Tagalog and English with subtitles in Arabic, all Laksis are Vietnamese, Chinese, English, French, German, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish, Tagalog, and Thai. Hello, matalinong manonood. Ngayon, inaanyayahan namin kayo sa lungsod ng Bacolod, ang kabisera ng Pilipinas sa gitnang lalawigan ng Negros Occidental. Negros Occidental ay sikat sa kanyang yaman ng natural na tanawin ng puting tabing dagat, mga talon at bundok. Ang mga tao ay sinasabing kaakit-akit, magiliw at talentado, lalo na sa kultural na sining. Negros ay kilala sa kanyang mayamang iba't ibang matamis na piling pagkain. Ito ay dahil Negros ay ang asukarera ng Pilipinas, lumilikha ng kalahati sa asukal ng bansa. Ang ating destinasyon dito sa Bacolod, ang lungsod ng ngiti, ay ang Negros Museo, na bahay ng isang kahangahangang koleksyon na makasaysayan at kultural na artepakto. Binuo noong 1996, ang Negros Museo sa katunayan ay may pambihirang mural at exhibit na inaalok sa kanyang bisita.
The purpose of this museum is to showcase the lifestyle and the sugar industry and also to preserve the history of this island of Negros. What is unique with this museum, because we feature the sugar industry. In the whole Philippines, this is only the museum that focus to the history of the sugar as well. We have a collection of toys here from 65 countries all over the world. And it is composed of almost 22,000 pieces of toys. These are the murals, and we have 9 murals here in the Negros Museum. Depicts the history of Negros before the Spaniards.
Sa Abril ng 1565, 6 taon bago itatag ang kabisera ng Pilipinas, Maynila, Espanyol mga galugad Miguel Lopez de Legazpi hindi inaasahang matuklasang isla ng Negros. Nakikilala niya ang mga katutubo doon sa nanirahan ng kaayuan.
This mural here is about the Tumandok backyard. Negros before is a tropical rainforest. It is full of trees and plants. Their houses are built tall. The reason why they built tall, number one, is for the ventilation. And if they live along the river banks, when the water goes up in the middle of the night, they are safe in their house. They practice to plant fruits and root crops for their daily needs.
Ang Negros Museo ay nagbibigay parangal sa iba't ibang kultura na nag-ambag sa kasaysayan ng lalawigan.
Here is all about the Spaniards. So the Spaniard introduced to us the religion, tradition, as well as education. So here on the table are some of the letters and records from the Spanish priests. Also, there's the Sacred Heart of Jesus. By the way, on the far end, is one of the oldest church in Negros. That small church there is the reproduction or the scale model of the Hinigaran Church that was built in 1858, made of limestone, bamboo, and bricks. No cement during the time. Here is the contribution of the Americans to the Philippines. In Negros, they contribute the milling companies and the steam locomotive that what you can see behind me. Steam locomotives here in Negros was milled by Baldwin of Philadelphia. Here is all about the Japanese. Negros Museum commemorates also the Japanese. The story is, American hire this Japanese to work for that cannon road going to Baguio. One of a well-known Japanese engineer assigned here in Negros by the name of Paul Kokichi Ishiwata of Atami City. He helped to build milling companies. Renovation of Bacolod Cathedral, University Club.
Sa gitna ng masiglang kasaysayan, Produksyon ng asukal ay umunlad sa rehiyong ito ng Pilipinas na mga taon hanggang ngayon. Tingnan natin sa ang paraan ng mga unang naninirahan sa Negros ang ginawang asukal. Ngunit una, isang panimula sa ilang masasarap na lokal na handog gawa sa kilalang asukal Negros.
Here are some of our native delicacies here in Negros. Most of our delicacies here are made out of sticky rice, coconut milk, and not to forget, sugar. So here, the first or the famous is piaya. This is a flour with sugar inside. Next is the pinasugbo. This is a banana coated with sugar. This is a peanut brittle. So this is made out of brown sugar, and these circles are peanuts. We have also the bayibayi. This is a bayibayi made out of sticky rice, coconut, and also sugar. So it's very sticky. And also the nearest is the butong-butong. This is a stick made out of sugarcane. So from the sugarcane juice, they will boil for several times the juice to make it more sticky and dry it up, and it will turn like this. And we call this butong-butong. Be sure that your teeth is strong. And lastly is ibos. Ibos is made out of sticky rice cooked in coconut milk and ginger. And this is wrapped with coconut leaves. And they will boil this for 30 minutes, and after that, that is the ibos. Behind me is the haciendero. Okay, what is an haciendero? Haciendero is a Spanish term for the owner of the farm. And this is how they look during the Spanish period. Their houses has towers like this. The reason why they have towers, so that they can look out their plantations and the workers in the fields. Most of the houses was built on the elevated area of the plantation so that they can see 360 degrees all over their plantation or their hacienda that we call here in the Philippines. Here is the haciendero salon. Haciendero salon showcase how the lifestyle of some of the well-to-do families here in Negros. So it showcases about their clothes, jewelries, rosaries, telephone. So this is the heirlooms of the sugar barons and baroness of Negros. Here, this photo of this beautiful lady here, her name is Marina Montinola Silos. She is from Negros. This was taken when she was 17 years old. That blouse and that shawl that she's wearing on the photo that is on the box, this is almost 150 years old clothes. She inherited that from her great-grandmother. But her secret of her beauty, she's eating vegetable every morning. Right now, she is 93 years old and still kicking and still goes to the mall and even in the park from time to time as her exercise. Without a cane, nor even the wheelchair. She walk alone, and also, that's the secret, eat vegetable. And this is her present photo. Here is the camarin. Camarin, that is where they process the sugar during the Spanish period. So behind me is the kawa. Actually, this is the smallest, the number one kawa. Because later on, we'll see the big one, and we call that the kawa numero 5, or the fifth kawa. By the way, why they have different sizes of kawa? Because when cooking a sugarcane juice, you need to cook it slowly so that you can get the right cooking or the process of muscovado sugar. All of the smoke will come out on the chimneys, and we call that the horno economico that you can found in some of the old plantations here in the island of Negros. And here is the big one. This is the number 5 kawa. So when they cook the sugarcane juice here, it's more warmer. By the way, this was introduced to us by the Chinese. Also, the sugarcane crusher was introduced to us by Chinese. And some of the memorabilia of the Chinese here, like their medicines, porcelain, and even they teach us to play mahjong. So on the top, or in the pillars, are family names of Chinese. They sound like Spanish family names, but they are originally Chinese. Here is the laboratory where they change the color of sugar. So here are the different colors of sugar. So after the sugar cane will be squeezed, what is left is the bagasso. Bagasso is the pulp or the skin of the sugar cane. So after the squeeze, what is left is the bagas. And the bagas, we process this or we use this to fuel milling companies, steam locomotives as well. Okay. The first sugar of Negros, we call that Muscovado. This is a brown sugar, dark brown. It was turned into a brown sugar, golden brown. Followed by the washed sugar, and it ends up in the refined white sugar. It was turned into white because they take out these molasses from this white sugar. The byproduct is the molasses. So behind me, and also in front of me, are some of the memorabilia of the milling company. We have here the multiplier and division machine, the old graduated cylinder. There's also the balance scale, and some of the memorabilia on the milling companies, and also their typewriter in the year 1930s by Boros Company. By the way, the Muscovado sugar is considered as one of the healthiest, or the healthiest sugar of all, because this is not processed like this, the refined sugar, because it is said they put chemicals to turn white for the refined sugar. Here is the batil. Batil is a kind of boat that they use here in Negros to drain the sugar from this island going to the Iloilo Island. So when this boat left here, the island of Negros, it only carries sugar. When they sell the sugar, they have already money. When this boat returned back here, they already bought products from other countries that is they sell in Iloilo.
Noong 1898, mga mamamayan ng Negros ng Pilipinas ay nanguna sa kilusang kalayaan kung saan walang napinsala. Salamat sa kanilang mga matalinong kapamaraanan at tapang.
Here is the Cinco de Noviembre. This is a Spanish word for 5th of November, 1898 Revolution of Negros. Here on the box is the old Bacolod City Hall. So here, beside me, is our national hero of the Philippines, Dr. Jose Rizal. Second, he is a museum goer, or we call him a patron of museums. Why? Because every time he travels, wherever he go, the first thing that he visit is a museum, so that he will know the culture, tradition, and everything about the place. Why Rizal was chosen as the hero of the Philippines? In my research, and also in the books in the curatorial department, Rizal fight through books. So here, the two books that he write is the Nolle Mitangere and El Filibusterismo. Rizal fight only through pen. So it's a peaceful revolution.
Salamat sa inyo, Ginoong Alunan Bayot at ang Negros Museo, sa pagtatanghal ng kaakit-akit na kasaysayan ng Negros Occidental at ang Pilipinas. Mula sa mapangakit na matamis na panghimagas sa mayamang maraming kulturang kontribusyon, dito maraming mga bagay-bagay para bisita sa buong mundo upang pasalamatan uko sa magiliw na kulturang Pilipino. Kahangahangang manonood, salamat sa inyong pagsali sa ang mundo sa ating paligid. Mangyaring manatili sa Suprema Maestra Television para sa salita ng karunungan, matapos ang dakilang balita. Nawa ang iyong mapagmahal at mapayapang mga gawa ay pagpalain ng langit. Wondrous viewers, thank you for joining us on the world around us. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television for words of wisdom after noteworthy news. May your loving and peaceful deeds be blessed by heaven.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/EE.